You are listening to SRM Insider. This is the Cyber Intelligence Briefing, your weekly roundup of the latest cybersecurity news and insights straight from SRM's leading global incident response team.
Welcome to another episode of SRM's Cyber Intelligence Briefing. I'm Kyle Schwaeble, and I'm joined by my colleagues Miles Arkwright, James Tytler, and Melissa DeOrio.
Hi, Kyle.
Heya.
Hi.
Well, we'll be covering seven stories on the podcast this week. Firstly, a deepfake video has convinced an employee to transfer millions of dollars to a cybercriminal. The popular remote access solution AnyDesk has suffered a breach. We're still seeing knock-on effects from the infamous Okta breach. The FBI have disrupted another botnet. Citibank is under fire for negligent data security practices. Mercedes-Benz and Football Australia have had accidental data exposure incidents. And Europcar denies that it has suffered a data breach. Well, James, I think first up this week, you and I were discussing earlier about this deepfake video, which seems to have cost an organization about $25 million.
Yeah, that's right. So a Hong Kong-based employee of an unnamed multinational firm sent $25 million US dollars to fraudsters after they were instructed to make the payment by a deepfake impersonation of their UK-based CFO on a video conference call. The employee believed they recognized other members of staff on the call, but these were in fact also deepfake impersonations, which were likely generated from publicly available footage of past meetings. This shows that it's becoming increasingly difficult to spot malicious AI-generated content online. Organizations should really consider how to make payment approvals and other sensitive functions resilient against this sort of rapidly emerging threat.
Yeah, absolutely. It is incredibly impressive and concerning to see some of the deepfake videos out there. Miles, can you share a little bit more information about this breach at AnyDesk, which I think had the potential to be quite severe, but maybe less severe than first thought?
Yeah, absolutely. So AnyDesk, who are a global remote access software company, has confirmed that it suffered a security breach after threat actors gained access to company production systems where they stole source code and code signing certificates. While AnyDesk assessed that the application was safe to use due to no evidence of end user devices being compromised, it revoked all login credentials to its web portal and urged users to reset passwords following reports that cyber criminals were selling stolen data on hacking forums.
Thanks, Miles. Yeah, I think this really highlights the importance of organizations that use AnyDesk software really need to reset their credentials as soon as possible and continue to then monitor those systems for suspicious activity.
Yeah, and I think they also said that we should be updating our AnyDesk versions to the latest version, not because the old version's vulnerable, but just because it will become invalid after they revoke these old certificates. Melissa, we're also seeing some additional fallout still today related to the Okta breach that happened last year.
Absolutely. Thanks, Kyle. Yeah, the latest in this kind of fallout that we're seeing is that state-backed hackers utilized the credentials that were obtained in that last Okta breach in order to access Cloudflare's internal server. So that breach originally happened in October of last year, but as Kyle mentioned, we're still seeing fallout from it. And most recently, Cloudflare disclosed that these hackers actually were able to access their internal Atlassian server in November of 2023 by using those credentials that were breached prior. And Cloudflare confirmed that they actually had failed to rotate service tokens and credentials of three service accounts that were leaked during that breach, which enabled the threat actors to gain access to their systems this time. So I think, you know, this really highlights the importance that organizations conduct a very thorough investigation and internal security review following a breach notification from a third-party supplier in order to ensure that they're mitigating that downstream impact to their organization.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with your recommendation more there. Absolutely very important thing that I think is not done often enough. James, we also saw that a new botnet seems to have been taken down by the FBI.
Yeah, that's right. So the FBI have announced they've taken down a botnet used by a Chinese state-linked group, which is known as Vault Typhoon. So a botnet is essentially a group of compromised internet-connected devices, which can be used by threat actors for a range of different malicious activities. In this case, the botnet comprised of end-of-life small office and home office routers, which were infected with the KV botnet malware. And the botnet was used to conceal the origins of attacks on the communications, energy, and transportation and water sectors in the US.
Yeah, that is interesting. It also comes in the wake of an announcement by the FBI director, Christopher Wray, that cyber criminals affiliated with the Chinese government are likely going to be targeting US critical infrastructure.
Thanks, Carl. Yeah, we can take a lot from that, but ensuring that end-of-life software is isolated or discontinued will help reduce the risk of your network from being compromised and exploited by hacking groups.
For sure. Absolutely, Miles. Miles, while I have you as well, I see that Citibank are coming under fire for some alleged weak security practices.
Yeah, that's right. So the New York Attorney General has actually sued Citibank for weak online security practices that contributed to the unauthorized access of customer accounts. The bank reportedly refused to reimburse victims of fraud, responded poorly to fraud notifications, and lacked key critical security controls such as logging and alerting on customer accounts. So what does this really mean? I think that organizations should be implementing robust data governance programs, which, amongst many things, will define key roles and responsibilities for protecting data and ensuring accountability and compliance with relevant regulations.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Miles. It looks like Mercedes-Benz has had a bad week. First, they lost Lewis Hamilton to their rivals at Ferrari. And now it seems like they may have accidentally exposed an authentication token online. Melissa, can you share some more?
Yeah, that's right, Kyle. Just keeps getting worse and worse for them. Essentially, they inadvertently exposed an authentication token to their internal GitHub repository on the internet, which essentially allowed for unrestricted access to the company's intellectual property and internal data until realized. And separately, Football Australia actually had a similar incident where they left their Amazon Web Service private keys exposed, which granted access to, among other things, player contract details, ticket purchase data from customers. And ultimately, both of these organizations attributed these breaches to human error and revoked the exposed tokens upon detection.
I think this really shows why it's so important to manage access to critical systems through multi-factor authentication and implement automated monitoring, and also have a comprehensive cybersecurity awareness program to help reduce the risk of human error.
Absolutely. Thanks, guys. And then finally, Europcar, the car rental company, they denied that they've suffered a data breach after a threat actor claimed to be selling the personal information of about 50 million Europcar customers on the dark web. Europcar claimed that the data has likely been generated by AI. I mean, they've cited inconsistencies between the sample data posted online and Europcar's own internal customer databases. Security experts, on the other hand, have suggested that the data may actually instead derive from several prior unrelated breaches. And I think it just raises the point that we should increasingly be skeptical of claims made by cyber criminals on the dark web and on these various marketplaces. The proliferation of recycled data makes it quite difficult to verify the origin and authenticity of breaches nowadays. Well, that brings us to an end of this week's episode. Please tune in again next week. Goodbye.
Thanks, Carl. Goodbye.